Good morning all. Now we see a second method of geophysical investigation, electrical resistivity method, that is the another word electrical method. The electrical method is properly used for the groundwater exploration. Electrical resistivity method is based on the difference in the electrical conductivity or the electrical resistivity of different soils and rocks. Resistivity defined as a resistance in ohm between the opposite phases of unit cube of material. And this is the equation. P is the resistivity in ohm, centimeter. R is the resistance in ohm. A is the cross sectional area, that is a centimeter square. L is the length of the conductor in centimeter. The resistivity values of the different soils are listed in table 1.4. If suppose we are taking the resistivity of soil and rock strata, these are the values and these are the material. If suppose the massive rock, the value is greater than 400 ohm. The shale and clay, if suppose we are in Karnataka regions, there are numbers of shale and clays, the resistivity value is calculated 1.0. Seawater in coastal regions, the resistivity value is 0.3 ohm. Wet and moist clay soils, that is the 1.5 to 3.0. It is the resistivity different regions at different types of resistance. Principle. All electrical methods are based on the fundamental fact that is different materials of the earth crust method possess widely different electrical properties, resistivity. Electrochemical activity and dielectrical constant are some of these properties that are generally studied through this method, result obtained from such studies when interpreted properly gives significantly useful clues regarding the nature and make of the subsurface material. Whatever the subsurface material present inside the earth, either it is ore, either it is groundwater, or either it is any type of rock body, which is find out in sounding techniques. Two common methods. The first one, equipotential method. In this method, two primary electrodes are inserted into the ground 6-7 meters apart from each other, 6-7 apart from each other, across which current introduced. The position of the primary electrodes remained fixed at subsequent investigations. Potential between the primary electrodes is determined with the help of two such electrodes and points of equal potential find out along the entire region under the investigation, which are joined to get equipotential lines. Under normal conditions, that is when the material below is a uniform nature and the equipotential lines would be regular in character, but in case when the material below is not uniform character, that is continuous patches of high or low conductivity, the equipotential lines probable locations of rock masses of different characteristics. Resistivity method. Second, it is similar equipotential method, but in this case it is the resistivity of the material of the subsurface which is determined, by which important interpretations are made. Hence, here is known as current is introduced through the two electrodes. The current electrodes which is inserted at some distance apart from each other. Potential gradient electrodes when measured directly with the help of two or more potential electrode placed at proper distance within the two outer current electrodes. A typical resistivity meter. A resistivity meter consists of both a voltmeter or current meter, ammeter, that is the ammeter. Most systems support of the ratio V upon I instead of each one separately. The resistance can be converted into resistivity using geometrical parameters. It is based on the array. That is, array means array. Most modern resistivity system typically utilize at least 4 electrodes. About 70% current applied by 2 electrodes at the surface stays within the depth equal to the separation of electrodes. In this case, the electrodes are driven approximately 20 centimeters into the ground and direct current, that is the DC. DC is a direct current or very low frequency, that is alternating current of known magnitude, is passed between the outer current electrodes, thereby producing within the soil an electrical field at the boundary conditions. And this is the actual subsurface investigation resistivity investigation figure. This is the voltmeter. This is the voltmeter. This is the current ammeter. And this one potential electrodes. This one potential, that is P1, P2. And current electrode, that is C1, C2. Both are current electrode. This is the horizontal surface. And it is the actual path of traveling. It is the actual path of electrical current accepted to the current electrodes. And here it is the actual machine of electrical meter, sounding meter. And here is the horizons, or different types of horizons are that. It is the horizon A and it is B. So A is giving a different types of idea of resistance, and B is also giving a different types of resistance. On that basis, we will calculate the resistance. Resistivity, how we measure it? Apply or non-potential difference measured with voltmeter to circuit with the resistivity material of known as length or cross-sectional area. Then measure current with ammeter. This gives resistance R. Spacing of current and potential electrode is of vital importance in this method. A number of arrangements have been suggested, of which Wenner arrangement is followed. In our syllabus, Wenner method is important. Wenner arrangement is followed quite commonly. In this arrangement, the potential electrodes are placed distance 1:3a, where the total distance between the current electrodes, the resistivity, that calculated formula, that is resistivity is equal to 2 pi dv upon I. That is, the V is the potential difference, I is the current ampere, and D is equal to 1/3a, where A is total distance between our electrode. This is the formula. For simple sounding, a Wenner array is used as shown. The resistivity is given. This is the Wenner array method. Mn and A. A is the spacing between the electrode. That is, the A is the spacing between the electrodes. It is the ampere. It is the voltmeter. And this is the actual path of current flow. It is the current electrode. And here it is the potential electrode. That is the Mm. Advantage of electrical method. It is very rapid and economical method. It is good up to 30 meter depth. The measurement 30 meter depth is profitable to investigate. The instrumentation is of this method is very simple. It is non-destructive method. Without touching the soil, this method is explored soil conditions. Disadvantage of electrical method. It can be detect absolutely different strata like rock and water. It provides no information about the sample. Cultural problems cause interference, that is power lines, pipelines, buried casings and fences. data acquisitions can be slow compared to other geophysical material, although the difference disappearing with the very latest techniques. Resistivity used map, where it is used? It is used map faults, map lateral extent or conductivity, containment plumes. Plumes means volcanic rock bodies, locate voids. Void means the spaces between the rocks or the water spaces between the rocks, present water spaces between the rocks. Map heavy metals, soil contamination. Delineate disposal areas, map paleo channels, means buried paleo river channels. Explore sand and gravels, map archaeological sites. Method, self potential method. Those electrical methods have involves measurement of natural electrical potential of the surface subsurface rocks are included under these headings. The natural potential may be due to electrochemical reactions between solution and surrounding subsurface rocks. These reactions are not always of the same order throughout the dimension of the rock masses, thereby creating a potential difference and the conditions of flow of current from one end to other end. Elongated or ore bodies, magnetite and pyrite etc. easily delineated is this method. So it is this method which is suitable for the mining, also the subsurface conditions ore bodies. Potential drop method, this includes variety of method in which electrical current artificially conducted introduced from the external source at a certain point and then flow the through surface material recorded at different distance. The behavior of the flow lines of the electrical current is directly related to the nature of subsurface material. The depth of penetration electrical current in this investigation broadly equal to the many attached to this generalization. The resistivity method envisages interpretation through qualitative as well as quantitative characters of the subsurface material, which is governed by two basic principles. First principle is, if material below of uniform nature, the resistivity values would be regular character. And second is, if material is non-uniform, that is consist of layer masses of different character, so it would be indicated regulators. In common practices, the resistivity given area is measured by the gradually increasing the distance between electrodes by changing the direction of profiles. Application. The first application in prospecting, the electrical method have been successfully employed in delineation of ore bodies occurring shallower depth or such surveys a great depth. This is not much help. Second, in table 2, some typical values ranges resistivity given as may be in rock exhibit great variation ranging from the high resistivity as greater than 10^5 ohms meters igneous rock, as low less than 1 ohm or clay. In civil engineering, the resistivity method have been widely used engineering investigation for determination of depth of bedrock. Instance in important project like dams, buildings and bridge foundation, where would be desirable that structure should rest sound hard rock rather than one overburden or soil. In location of geological structure like fold, buried valleys, crushed and fractured zones, shearing faulting, location aquifers, water bearing zones could be easily interpreted basis known as resistivity values, moisture rich rocks and dry rocks. Some are more applications. Beyond these applications, first one is characteristic subsurface hydrogeology, determination depth of bedrock, overburden thickness, determination of depth of groundwater, map stratigraphy, map clay aquitards, map salt water intrusions, map vertical extent, Then groundwater contamination, estimation of land fill thickness. Electrical resistivity method follow groundwater investigation. How to investigate? Electrical method or geophysical prospecting are well established and the most important method for groundwater investigation. Second, a hard rock without pores or fracture, dry sand without water or clay are very resistive, several tens thousands ohm. Second, a porous fracture rock bearing free water has resistivity which is depends on resistivity of water and the porosity of the rock, see below, several tens, several thousand meter ohm meter. And impermeable clay layer which is has bound water has a low resistivity, the several unit and several tens ohm per meter. Mineral ore bodies, iron ore sulfides have heavy low resistivity due to their electronic conduction, usually lower, much lower than 1 ohm. Groundwater detection. To identify the presence groundwater of resistivity measurement, one can look absolute value of the groundwater resistivity through Archie law of practical ranges of freshwater resistivity 10 to 100 ohm, between 10 to 100 ohm meter. A most usual target aquifer resistivity can be between 50 to 2000 ohm meter. Most consider detecting groundwater, a hard rock resistance environment, a low resistivity anomaly will be the target while the clay or salty conduct environment. In case high resistivity anomaly, which is the most probably correspond freshwater. So these are the detections. Thank you.